Hi, and welcome back to another video in the Azure Cloud Native series. My name is Gary Hope. I'm a Program Manager on the Azure Cosmos DB team. In this video, I'll briefly touch on what makes Azure Cosmos DB a great database for your Cloud Native applications and have a look at some of the levers you can use to optimize cost when leveraging it for building your highly scalable cloud applications. Azure Cosmos DB is a fully managed NoSQL database for modern app development with SLA-backed speed and availability, automatic and instant scalability, and open source APIs for MongoDB, Cassandra, and other NoSQL engines. As a NoSQL database, it provides developers with the agility to efficiently support the modern app development lifecycle by handling all the data as it evolves over the lifetime of the application, and effortlessly maps back to the object-oriented programming models most commonly used. Using the default SQL Core API and JSON documents to store your application data provides you with a schema-agnostic way of storing your data so you're not faced with the overhead of having to model your data first into tables and columns, then understand the relationship between them even before you start building your application. As a fully managed Azure service, Azure Cosmos DB provides your application with unmatched throughput, latency, and consistency guarantees. Through its by-design support of scale-out architecture, it provides cost-effective linear application scalability as your application grows when compared to the scale-up architectures typically required by relational database systems. This is great when you're using capabilities like AKS Autoscale to right-size your AKS pod or cluster. Now your application can scale to meet the demands without having to worry about any limits inherent in the database layer. The Azure Cosmos DB latency guarantee I previously mentioned provides you with a single-digit application reads and writes, so your application will always be snappy and provide your users with consistent, high-performance user experience. With its turnkey global data distribution capabilities, Azure Cosmos DB can automatically replicate your data around the world with support for every Azure region. This also provides your application with continuous service availability in the unlikely event of an Azure region becoming unavailable, and backs the five nines availability. The ability to support database writes across multiple regions enables you to place your data for both reads and writes as close to your users as their nearest Azure data center. There are many ways to reduce costs and easily manage cloud native applications with Azure Cosmos DB. Let me briefly introduce you to the concepts we've talked about in a bit more detail. Let's jump into the portal. Here I have a pre-provisioned Cosmos DB account. The account is named Cloud Native Demo. Within the account, we have a database called unimaginatively Demo Database. And within that database, we have a container called Logistics Data. You guessed it, the apps is a logistics app, tracking and managing vehicles and the packages they transport. We will have a look at the data in the container in a minute. Let's have a look first at the global replication feature I mentioned earlier. If you look to the right of the screen, you can see data currently resides in West US 2. Enabling a copy of that data to be automatically, transparently replicated to East US 2 region is just a matter of one click. Configuring multiple region writes is also just a matter of enabling the option. These are great capabilities, however, they come at a cost. So think carefully about data availability and locality requirements for your application. If you don't need them, turn them off. I'm going to discard these changes as this is a development environment and I don't need them now. Let's have a quick look at how the data is stored. Within our demo database, I'm going to drill into the logistics data container. Here you can see a list of JSON documents stored in our database. If you click on a document, you will see the data within it. In this case, vehicle data with attributes such as vehicle identification number, the age of the battery, and what state the vehicle was registered in. Azure Cosmos DB provides a rich query language to filter and project your data into a format tailored for your app's requirements. Here's a select statement for the container. These first records are the same as what we saw earlier. I however know there is slightly more interesting data in this container. It's a NoSQL database, so I don't need to create separate container to store different types of data. Here's a query pulling back the trip data. It has more interesting structure, some standard attributes. However, here we can see package data embedded in the trip document. Whilst Azure Cosmos DB supports flexible schema, it's important to think about how you model your data to support efficient queries and in turn reduce the database resource requirements for your application. I'll link to some additional resources on this topic for you to explore. Let's talk a little more about the granular performance and controls we mentioned earlier. When using Azure Cosmos DB, you pay for the storage used to store your data and the operations you perform against the database. Any operation you perform consumes some amount of database resources. These are expressed in request units, or RUs. The more challenging the operation, the more request units it'll cost. So choosing the right offer is all about selecting how Cosmos DB will deliver these request units while you're using the database. The first offer that's been available on Azure Cosmos DB since the service launched is provision throughput. This offer lets you configure the amount of throughput you expect the database to deliver and requires you to plan ahead for the right performance level to cover your application's needs. Note that this offer delivers throughput expressed in request units per second. By configuring my database for 4,000 request units per second, I'm guaranteed that this amount of throughput will be available, which is great for applications that receive sustained traffic. I also get very strong guarantees over latency and availability of my database. Now, it's pretty rare that request traffic is as steady as shown here, as application traffic often varies over time. This can lead to unused capacity if the amount of throughput we provisioned is substantially higher than the throughput your application needs. So when traffic patterns are predictable, Azure Cosmos DB lets you manually change the amount of provision throughput to make sure that the capacity you provision matches the capacity you need, either through the portal, writing an automation script, or programmatically in your code. Let's have a look at what practically provisioning throughput looks like. Here is the same account and database and container we spoke about earlier. Let's provision a new database and container for us to test with. I'm going to call it My Test DB. Imaginative, I know. Cosmos DB provides you with the ability to provision throughput at both the database and container level. Provisioning throughput at the database level, like we're doing now, allows the throughput to be shared amongst multiple containers, up to 25 of them. This supports separate parts of your application and data, and potentially even separate applications data that you don't want to store in a single container, but for which you're happy to share performance considerations. Here we choose the number of request units per second we want to provision for our database. I'll leave it at the default 400 request units per second for now. I'll call our first container, container 1, set the partition key, and click create. I won't talk much here about partitioning and how to choose the right partition key to support the sharding of your data across the multiple physical resources as we scale the database out. However, I will share a link to additional materials at the end of the video, given that choosing an appropriate partition key is also important to ensuring good performance as you scale your application up. There we go, we have a new database and container within it using shared database throughput. It's not sharing it with any other container at the moment, so let's create another container. I'm going to select the existing database, provide a container name, you guessed it, specify the partition key, and click create. Here we have our two containers now sharing the same throughput. Maybe that 400 request units per second is not large enough. Let's scale that up to, say, 2000. Here we have it, our original database and container, and our new database with two new containers sharing database level throughput. But what happens if I have specific throughput requirements for part of my application data? No problem, we can create a container for that data with dedicated throughput at the container level within the same database. I choose our existing database. Let's call this container dedicated container and specify a partition key as we did before. However, now I'm going to select that we want to provision dedicated throughput and specify the amount of throughput required. and click OK. Here you can see our new dedicated container. If we go back to the overview, you can see that it has its own 2000 request units per second, and we can now adjust that throughput for this container independently. That covers manual provisioning scenario using the portal. Let's have a look at adjusting the throughput to match your application's needs through automation. Here I'm back in the portal. Let's open up Cloud Shell and have a look at what's involved in setting up throughput using the Azure CLI. Using the AZ Cosmos DB CLI command, I can show the throughput of a dedicated container we've just configured, 4000 RU. I can now, using the AZ Cosmos DB CLI command again, set the throughput, in this case, to 2500 request units per second. A quick refresh of the portal, and here you can see almost instantaneously the throughput is adjusted. And we can do the same thing using PowerShell. Using the get Cosmos DB SQL container throughput commandlet, we can see the provision throughput. We can now set the throughput using the update AZ Cosmos DB SQL container throughput commandlet, in this case down to 2500 again. So as you can see, modifying the amount of throughput using PowerShell or the Azure CLI is super easy and allows you to match the provision throughput to your predicted application's requirements for database capacity. This automation can be added to the existing automation used to scale your application.